praise the Lord. Welcome to another edition of Live with New Life, Life of Excellence program. What a blessing it is to be with you today, isn't it?
It is a blessing. We're excited about talking to you today. It's our Wednesday morning broadcast, and we have a plan for you. We have a purpose, don't we?
Yes. And, you know, the Word of God is going to minister to you today and encourage you. So right now, we want to encourage you. Let everybody know that New Life is live online right here at newlife313.life. Also, you can share this on your Facebook page. Share it on your Twitter, your social media. Soon it'll be on YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube page. And then, of course, it's always in the archives right here at newlife313.life. And we just want to bring the Word of God to you. We are excited about what God is doing in the kingdom of God. I know it looks bad out there with the Supreme Court passing all these stupid laws to redefine what sex is. I won't get into that. But you know what, beloved of God, with all the riots, all the looting, all the problem, but God is always in control, and none of this has caught him off by guard. And you're going to be okay if you learn to trust.
Amen. We have to trust in the Lord. We have to be ready for whatever comes at us and be prayed up and ready to seek the Lord and move in the direction that he's got for us. And that's what we're talking about today, isn't it?
Yes, we are. In fact, last night, me and you sat down and I said, honey, pray about what you think we ought to speak about tomorrow and share with the people during that 30 minutes of renewal. And the first thing that she spoke was trust.
In the Lord.
Amen. So we're going to get right into the Word today, and we hope that it'll bless you and encourage you. We have some great things, but we want you to know that you are important to the kingdom of God, and you are important to New Life 313 Ministries, and we're so grateful to you. As the leaders of New Life 313 Ministries, you know, we're Jay and Connie Hurd. We're the face of New Life 313 Ministries, but we have all of our board members and our pastors who pray for you as well.
Yes,
Pastor Troy and Mary Ivy, Pastor Louise McConnell, they pray with you. Pastor Bill Hurt, they pray for you. Every one of them ministering from around California and out west, ministering for you. It's not just us two,
right,
it's you as well. And you know, God has been real good to us, hasn't he?
He's been wonderful.
He's been blessing us.
Yes, he has. And you know what you said about people coming together and praying and how our people are praying for you. And we lift up you guys every day.
We lift up
our families, our partners, New Life, past, present, and future. And the good thing is this, the Bible says that with much counsel is much success.
Yes.
So you've got to have that counsel in order to be successful to move forward. It can't just be what's in your own mind. You've got to be reaching out to God, but you've got to also be reaching out to people and the right people.
That's right. And today we're going to talk about trust in the Lord. Yes. I'm going to ask my wife, hallelujah, to read a scripture, but first I'm going to pray for you. Dear Heavenly Father, we send the word of encouragement and love and power and forgiveness to all those that are watching this live and those who are tuning in later. Lord, we want you to bless them. Minister to them, and Lord, during this 30 minutes of renewal, let their life be changed. And Lord, we give you all the praise and the glory. Woo! In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know what? Before we get into the Word, we received a beautiful letter from a pastors out west who attended one of our revival. And I've asked Connie, read that part from what they said to us, how sweet it is. This is your New Life 313 Ministries. This is what God is doing through you by being a part of this ministry and supporting this ministry. We get to get beautiful letters of support like this.
Amen. This letter, like you said, is from some pastors in California, and they attended our revival. And this says, we talk of our revival with you. And then it says, Sister Carlene is anxiously praying about a revival with us again.
That's their minister of music, Sister Carlene, is what they told us, yes.
Yes, she came. And it says, God healed her blood condition when you prayed for her. Robert and I were so motivated by your service. Now, praise God. See, that's what this ministry is about. And we're excited too. Pastors Robert and Pastor Linda, thank you for writing.
Amen. It encouraged us. That's right.
Yes.
And Sister Carlene, what's her name?
Carlene.
I'm glad God healed you. And it, but it is not us, it is the Lord.
Amen.
We just pray the prayer of faith.
Yes.
But it's the prayer of faith that shall save the sick, not Jay and Connie Heard of New Life. It's the prayer of faith. And what a wonderful testimony. Amen.
Good.
So let's get right into the word after that great testimony. We're going to talk today about trust.
Amen. You ready for the scripture?
Give the word of God. Amen.
All right. We're going to go to Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. So you can turn there, or you can just listen, or you can write it and read it later and meditate on it.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Yeah.
And lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths.
Wow.
Isn't that good?
Trust in the Lord. Yeah, how many times have we been through a battle and somebody just said, well, trust God. Praise the Lord. Just trust God. And you wanted to slap them. Because you're like, you don't know the hell I'm in. What are you talking about? Trust God. That's all I've ever done is trust God, and still I'm in this hell. But that's not what the Bible says. It doesn't say, trust in the Lord with all your heart, except when you're in a battle for a long time.
That's right. It doesn't. It says to trust in the Lord and lean not to your understanding. Because our understanding is what's happening, our physical, the natural, everything that's happening to us right now.
Right.
The battle you're in. See, when you're in that battle, all you can think of is, oh my gosh, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? But see, there's the stop. Mm-hmm. And trust in the Lord
with all
of your heart and soul.
Now, that's the key right there, with all your heart. Jesus said, if you ask anything, believing, and do not doubt in your heart.
Do not doubt. That's the key.
Do not doubt.
That's right.
And see, so many times we go like this, oh, God, I love you, Lord. I praise you. I thank you, Jesus. Woo, God's so good. And then we go out the door, and reality hits us in the face. We're like, oh, I don't know if God can really do that. I don't know if God's going to be able to do that. Man, that's a big miracle. And see, that's a lie from the devil.
Yeah, it is. Absolutely.
You're not trusting in the Lord with all of your heart. You're not. You're leaning to your understanding.
Your understanding, and not on God's wisdom and God's sovereignty and his mercy and his grace that is protecting you every day. See, we just want to take everything into our own hands. And I can tell you from experience, whoa, Lord, when I take things in my own hands, I mess things up. I have messed a lot of things up, but thank God for God's grace that gets me back on track.
And you know, you may be listening today, you may be saying, you know, I've been in this salvation for a long time. I don't need you to tell me, trust the Lord, I do. You may be saying, I've been a preacher. I don't need you to encourage me, trust. I know how to live by faith. Well, you're not the ones we're talking to. We're talking to the ones like us who have been saved and been in the ministry and still have struggled by leaning to our own understanding. See, when you lean to your own understanding, you fall into worry.
There you go.
And Jesus said, why worry?
Mm-hmm.
Yet worrying won't change it. See, faith and worry are the polar opposites.
Yes,
is that how you say that? Polar opposites? They are the polar opposites. And your worry sometimes will outweigh your faith and your trust in God. And that's because you're leaning on your understanding of the issue. You're leaning. See, you watch the news. You read the newspaper. You go to church, and all you hear is this group talking gossip over here, or your prayers didn't get answered exactly the way you wanted, or when you wanted, or they haven't even got answered yet.
Yeah.
So you start leaning to your understanding of, it must not be God's will. God doesn't love me. God doesn't care. God's not going to make anything happen for me. I must have sin in my life.
And
I must have done something.
Stop.
You
have to stop.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you, that goes right into this. I have to tell you, the Bible says to renew your mind. In Romans, it says to renew your mind.
That's it.
Daily. It also says that God...
Wait a minute. Say
daily,
that again. Back that up.
Renew your minds daily.
Yes.
And that daily, God loads us with benefits. Well, if we are carrying on with all of our fears and everything playing out and just letting it, because if you don't stop it, it will continue to play. You've got to replace those thoughts. And here is the scripture I want to give you for that. Philippians 4 and 8. Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is any virtue in...
Virtue is power.
Is power. And if there is anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things.
Do what now?
Meditate.
See, when we meditate on the problem more than the solution, that's where we lean to our own understanding. When we meditate on the doctor's report more than the God of healing, that's where we lean to our own understanding. If we meditate on the negative, they tell you, if you meditate on the negative, you will become negative.
Yes.
You know, that's why it's a daily, reminder to remind yourself. You need to remind yourself to quit worrying.
That's right. You have to continue to. And see, it's not easy. I text my mother about something and she said, it ain't for sissies.
Yeah. So
Christianity ain't for sissies.
That's right.
I'm going to tell you, it is all about renewing your mind and keeping your faith and knowing and start filling your mind with good thoughts and praying for those. You know, I've been reading some pastors' literatures from old time, from long ago, and one of the things that helped some of his parishioners, he said they couldn't get their minds out of the negative. He said, repeat this daily. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Now, we say that, but when you repetitively say it, it gives you some energy because I've been doing it. It gives you some, I can do this because Jesus is right here with me. His word says I can do it, and I will.
And, you know, this is something that we need to learn. And it's just going to shock you. We cannot conquer worry.
That's right.
Because worry is a part of the flesh, and we are daily fighting the flesh. We can't conquer worry. You may want to, but you can't. But you can do this. You can get through it, push through it, by reminding yourself these three, four words, trust in the Lord.
Amen.
And that will combat worry. And, you know, I was sharing with my wife that I was listening to a minister, and I'm going to read some of the things that he said about worry, and his list is amazing, and it spoke to me, and I shared some of it with her, and we want to share it with you today. This is from Chuck Swindoll, a great minister of the gospel, and he made a list about worry, and he says this. He said, if you choose to worry, you do not trust. Leading to your understanding. If you choose to worry, you do not trust. Then he said, when you try to fix what is impossible, you do not trust.
That's right.
What does the Word of God say? What is impossible with man is?
Possible with God.
That's what the Word of God says.
Yes.
So when we try to fix the impossible, we do not trust.
That's right.
He said this. I love this one. And how many times have we done this? I'll say it for me. When you hurry ahead and you do not wait on the Lord to change things, you do not trust. How many times have we ever tried to change things on our own and boy, all hell broke loose?
Right. That's leaning to our own understanding.
Oh, that's it.
Trying to fix the problems.
You can't fix.
Plan A, B, and C.
You know, it's kind of like that guy said, you can fix a broke arm, you can fix a broke leg, you can fix a broke neck, but you can't fix stupid. And you know what? Some of us, hallelujah, just stay in stupid. We think, well, God didn't do it, so I'm going to do it. And then we say, oh, God, I'm sorry I did it. Then we go back, God didn't do it, so I'm going to do it again. Oh, God, I'm sorry I did it. And we do it again and do it again. And then this is what he said. I love this. He said, when you lay awake at night, turning and twisting, you do not trust. I remember a ministry that was going through a trial, and a couple of their secretaries and leaders were laying awake all night long, tossing and turning. They'd come to the office, their eyes would be puffy, and they would look tired, and they were drained. When the leaders of this ministry would come in, they were just, praise the Lord, how y'all doing? They looked rested.
Yeah.
And finally, one of the secretaries turned to one of the other leaders and said, they don't look tired or worried at all. What's going on? So they went and asked them. They said, you know what? We've been worried for y'all. We've been tossing and turning all night. What? And you guys look refreshed. And their answer was so unique. They said, what are y'all tossing and turning about and worrying about? They said, everything that's going on in the ministry, everything, it's a heavy load. And they said, look, we've given it to God. So when we gave it to God, the Bible says he gives his beloved rest. Woo, hallelujah. You know, some of y'all laying out there tossing and turning. Get to sleep.
Exactly. And you know what? We're guilty of that. We're guilty of that.
Yeah.
We just want to carry the weight of the world. And what he said about you cannot keep worry from coming in because it's going to pummel you. It's constant.
Yeah.
But when you renew and you do these things right here that we're talking about, you can change your situation and your mind and start heading in the right path.
You know what, beloved of God? You must push worry and fretting aside and say, Lord, at this moment, I trust in you.
Amen.
This is another thing that Chuck Swindoll did or wrote. I love what he said. He said this, when you doubt biblical principles and the promises that are right in front of you, and you hear them all the time, every time you go to church, and I added that part, when you doubt those principles, you do not, and I even put it capitalized, you do not trust.
That's right.
If you got the Bible right here in front of you, and you're not obeying it, you do not trust. Oh, beloved of God, let me get through this real quick. When you listen to human counsel and give a higher priority to what they're saying than the principles you've learned from God,
That's it. You do not trust.
See, you just said, with much counsel comes success. But when we take human counsel above godly counsel and above what God's word says, we don't trust.
No, but that, and there again, that's what you've got to do is surround yourself with godly people who know the principles of the Lord. And seek
exactly.
and agree together.
Amen? Exactly. And this is the whole thing right here, that God wants us to know this. Let me just finish this. I'm getting ahead of myself.
Okay, go.
These are two good ones that he said, when you, I'm going to talk to you, when you manipulate and maneuver the situation,
because
you think you can do it better and quicker than God, you do not trust.
Wow.
When you step in and take charge without praying or being led by the Spirit, you show those around you and you show God that you put your trust more in your abilities than you do in God. Woo! My goodness, that's powerful. There's some more. I won't go into all of them, but I mean, that is a powerful word.
It is.
I don't know who we're talking to today, but I want you to be encouraged, whether it's spiritual, emotional, mental, physical, financial, whatever you're facing today, trust in the Lord. It didn't say trust in the Lord when you have all your bills paid and you got multiple millions in the bank. It didn't say trust in the Lord when the doctor's saying, man, you're the healthiest I've ever seen. It didn't say trust in the Lord when your kids are not in jail and when everybody's not strung out on drugs. He didn't say trust in the Lord, hallelujah, when, hallelujah, there's no riots and that. No, he said trust in the Lord at all times.
Woo, praise God. He's preaching now.
I had to pull myself back on that.
I know you did. I saw that.
Uh-huh.
You've got to trust in God. You've got to not lean on your own understanding. And you have got to move forward. See, analysis paralysis.
Yeah.
You can be in a place where you cannot
overanalyze
because you overanalyze your situation.
That's
and can you imagine the worry and the analyzation? And you don't move. Or you stay in the same situation. Or you repeat the same things you've constantly repeated. See, you can move forward, but you've got to make some changes because sometimes what worked in the past aren't going to work in the future. You've got to continually evolve, but the message of God, the purpose of God for your life stays the same.
That's it. God is always constantly driving you towards your purpose.
Amen.
You're the one who gets off the path.
That's it.
You're the one. It's just like Balaam. His ass had to, donkey. King James says ass, but his donkey had to literally push him into a wall. Well, praise God. This is live. So, but, you know, his donkey had to constantly push him into the wall to where Balaam got so angry, he was beginning to beat that donkey, and the donkey began to talk.
Yeah.
And sometimes it takes a jackass to talk to you to get you to realize, trust in the Lord.
Oh,
amen. I'm going to get a lot of problems on that one. I'm sure. A lot of people say, brother, you shouldn't talk like that for Jesus. But
it's in the Bible.
I'm speaking truth to you today.
Yes.
God is trying to get your attention to say, trust in the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'll tell you, we know some great business people. And those people, they constantly trust in the Lord.
Amen.
Even when they worry and they push aside and say, no, I'm not going to give into it. I'm going to trust in the Lord. And God has blessed them and they have succeeded. Mm-hmm. See, you cannot, pastor, if you're dealing with problems right now, you're dealing with those people in your church, other churches that are coming against you, don't fret.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord. This is what the Word of God says in Psalms 124. In verse 1, Psalms 124, verse 1. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say. Now let's say this. If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, now may Jay and Connie say. That was your cue. Now, may Jay and Connie Hurt say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, now may you say.
Yeah.
If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us. Psalms 124, verse 4. Then the waters would have overwhelmed us. The stream would have gone over our soul. The proud waters would have gone over our soul. But blessed be the Lord who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Verse 8. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Oh, amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. See, God made it all. He is the ultimate help. He's the beginning and the end. And we have got to know that no matter what situation we're dealing amen. With, whatever path you're looking for, whatever direction, because we know a lot of people, and they are looking for, how do we get out of this?
Yeah.
What's our next move? What do we do? God, we just want your perfect will. Isn't that what we all want, to be in the perfect will of God? We've got to move forward and believe that God will direct you if you listen.
You've got to listen.
We're praying, we're fasting, and we're listening to the Lord for our path, your path.
In fact, right now, New Life 313 Ministries is... we just came out of a 21-day prayer and fasting, but right now we are in a time of prayer.
Right.
God has opened an opportunity for us, and it's a huge step of faith. And Connie and I, the Bible says the secrets of the Lord are with them that fear him.
Yes.
This is the first time we're publicly saying it. We haven't even shared it with our leaders yet. Because me and Connie have been praying, and we should have, you know, we don't want to give away anything before we share it with our leaders. But there is a big step of faith that we're praying. And it's not a little step of faith. It's a big step of faith that has been presented to us, an area that could literally change the direction of this ministry and bless this ministry and bless the world through this ministry. And you know what we've done? The last few days, we've just been praying and saying, Lord, we trust that yes. you're going to give us the right word.
Amen.
We trust that you're going to give us the right direction. We don't want to just take man's word for it. We want a confirmation. That's what Gideon did.
Yes.
See, God yes. is going to raise up some Gideons today.
Amen.
I believe with all my heart that God is going to give New Life 313 Ministries some Gideons, some
amen.
300s, some hallelujah, mighty warriors that are going to fight the battle with us to bring about a revival and bring about what God has for this ministry. We want
amen.
You to be a part of it. But right now, we're trusting in the Lord that by the end of this week, we will know the exact direction to take. Isn't that right?
That's right. And the Bible says, how can two walk together
yeah.
except they be agreed? And if you're couples out there, you're partners, you're married, and
believe
I mean
together.
Partners as business partners, I wanted to clarify that. Whenever you believe things together and you are of one mind and one accord,
yeah.
there is nothing that you cannot do together. Because God says with agreement, he will answer your prayers. So we've got to believe, you've got to believe for what you're looking for. And the Bible says a righteous man's steps
are ordered
by the Lord.
Right.
And see, when God's in it, and you're doing and praying and seeking him, he is directing your steps. And another thing that I thought of is, you know, timing. God's timing is everything. It's not our time, because we want it. We want it now.
Yeah, we want it right now.
Yeah,
yeah.
And sometimes we get in these arrangements or business deals or things that we think, okay, this is it. Okay, this is it. And you've got to step out there and try new things. But if it's not it, then God's going to remove it. And he's going to put you back on the path toward what is your life's purpose.
Whatever you're facing today, beloved of God, this is not a chastising.
No.
This is something God spoke to us.
Amen.
Last night, in fact, before we got this message together, we prayed. Because one thing Connie and I want to do, not only, I mean, we work together, we live together, we go to the gym together. We're around each other all the time. But one thing that is very serious to us is this. We have to have the same mind and the same vision and the same
that's right.
goal for what God has put in our heart. And we have to trust God together.
Amen.
If you're battling right now in your trust with God, find somebody of a like mind, like she just said, that will believe with you and trust God with you. Amen. Not somebody that says, oh, I don't know about that.
Exactly.
It's like, you know what? You need to leave. I need to talk to somebody that does know about that.
What Amen. Is it? You say doubters, powders, and do without.
Doubters, powders, and do without.
Them. Don't. Yeah,
that's what I was raised. And you said, my God, oh, you doubters, powders, and do without. Ah! Amen. But right. God wants us to get together. And God wants us to bless. We're going to pray for you today that God will encourage your faith.
Amen.
That I know there's people that are going to view this live, others viewing it at a later time. The Lord loves you.
Yes, He does.
Maybe you've been battling in your spirit. Maybe you're someone that was in church, but you've kind of backslid and you've gotten away from God and you just say, God, I don't even know what's going on. God loves you today. He wants to forgive you. See, our ministry is about rebuilding lives, restoring hope, renewing vision. We don't care what you've done, when you did it, why you did it, where you did it, who you did it with. And all we care about is that you know Jesus, ask for forgiveness, and move on in your life.
Amen.
And trust in the Lord. Trust. I know there's someone today, you're facing a huge financial problem. And you say, oh, that's just a random. No, I'm speaking directly to you.
Amen.
Because you know who you are, and I can tell you where you're at right now. And you're thinking, God, what am I going to do? But God says, trust in me.
Yes.
Have I not brought you out before, and can I not do it again?
Praise God, do
See,
it.
When the children of Israel left Egypt, the Bible says they spoiled the Egyptians. They left with silver. They left millionaires.
They did.
They left with gold, silver, jewels. And the word of God says not one feeble one was among them. That means if they had any type of sickness before they left, they were healed.
Amen.
Trust.
And that was trusting God.
Trusting
because
God.
They had to trust God to make that move to step out. To leave, and then look, once they made that decision and they began to trust and move forward, God blessed them with the spoils.
But this is the key. You just said something that sparked my spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We only have a few minutes left. When they begin to trust in the word of Moses that everything's going to change, we're leaving.
Yeah.
Then guess what happened? Pharaoh fought them and 10 plagues came.
Yeah.
And the people begin to say, leave us alone, leave us alone. He said, trust in the Lord. And this is key.
Yes.
The plagues came, but not near their dwelling.
That's right.
It didn't go
That's
into Goshen.
Right.
It stayed on this side. Beloved, even when you're trusting God, you're going to face opposition and face battles.
Amen.
But you're coming out of this. You know, we love and appreciate you so very much.
Yes, we do.
Our ministry is a viewer-supported ministry. We are supported by men and women of God like you. We want you to connect with New Life. We want to pray with you. We want to pray for you and your family. And we want you to be a part of what God's going to do. In fact, you can go right now to your smartphone, your tablet online, and you can download Church App Live. It's called Church App Live. And when you download that, it'll ask what city. You put Tulsa, Oklahoma, and then it says New Life 313 and a couple other ministries. You choose New Life 313 Ministries. You can download our app on your phone and carry us around everywhere you go.
Right. Like a podcast.
Like
you
a podcast.
You can watch us. You can listen to us. You can tune in live when you're driving down the street, but put it on the console.
There you go. And your new blog, Let's Get Together, that she's going to be sending out words, not only to women, but men and children,
Amen.
Encourage them. You can get that right there on your phone. That's Church App Live. Download that today. Type in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and put New Life in. And beloved of God, we thank you for your support.
Yes,
right
sir.
Now, as you're watching this, you can go to the Connect Give button there. You can connect with us. You can donate to newlife313.life. You can send in your prayers, requests, and your offerings to New Life 313. Our address is on the website right there. You can text to give. The information's right there on the website.
Yes.
If you're watching on YouTube, go to our website and connect with us. We need you to pray with us. As I said, in the next few days, we're going to be praying for great things to happen because God is opening a great, tremendous door of opportunity.
Amen.
And we need your prayers and your financial support. We love you so much. Thank you for taking time to be with New Life today for these 30 minutes of renewal. We love and appreciate you so much. Heavenly Father, we speak a word of life, encouragement, and strength
Yes.
over all of those who are viewing today. Lord, we thank you for those who financially support New Life, pray for New Life,
Yes.
God, and God back New Life with their love. Bless them. In Jesus' name we
Yes.
pray. Amen.
Amen.
Beloved of God, once again, this is Jay and Connie Hurt, New Life 313 Ministries. We are rebuilding lives, restoring hope, renewing vision, and
you have purpose.
Yes,
we
you
love
do.
You. God
we love you,
you
so much. God bless.